Hello everyone, I am Antorin Talukdar. I am currently working as a conservator and restorer at the Mehrangarh Museum Trust under the Tata Trust Art Conservation Initiative. I hope everyone is doing well and keeping safe during this difficult time. So today I'll be discussing with you all in brief about the conservation decision making, the process and its challenges. So to begin with, what is conservation? The conservation is defined as the process that aims to prolong the lifespan of an artifact or collection by mitigating the deterioration factors and stabilizing the artifact in its present condition. To further proceed on the discussion, let's look upon the preventive conservation.
The preventive conservation aims at avoiding and minimizing future deterioration or loss, and they are carried out within the context or the surroundings of an artifact or a collection. These measures or actions are indirect, and therefore they do not interfere with the materials and neither modify the appearance of an artifact. Here you can see in this image how a preventive conservation is implied to an artifact. The archival box that is used to store the paper object further prevents it from the deterioration factors such as dust and dirt. The rolling and packaging of a textile prevents it from different deterioration factors in the storage or cabinet. Now coming to the remedial conservation actions are directly applied to an artifact considering the factors of deterioration and by mitigating the risk and stabilizing it. These actions are only carried out when the artifact is in such a fragile condition or deteriorating at such a rate that they could be lost in a relatively short time. These actions sometimes modify the appearance of the artifact, and therefore the conservator should try to avoid any interventions that can damage the identity and significance of the artifact. Here in this image, you can see the conservators of Mehrangarh Art Conservation Center performing remedial conservation on a miniature painting and on a manuscript. The restoration, on the other hand, is directly applied to a single and stable artifact aimed at facilitating its appreciation, understanding and use. These actions are only carried out when the artifact has lost part of its significance and function through the past alteration and deterioration. Most often, the restoration actions modify the appearance of the artifact. Here is an example of a terracotta object where the restoration is done to complete it by filling up the losses. The restoration process in this case is followed by the remedial conservation done to the object to provide stability. It is essential to conduct a preliminary inspection of the artifact or collection before receiving it to the conservation center. This step helps to identify if there is any active deterioration going on in the artifact that can cause damage to the entire collection. They are inspected in a quarantine space, and if any active deterioration such as fungal growth or insect attack is observed, they are isolated and treated separately to avoid spread to the other artifacts. The documentation and the condition assessment report is a primary tool that a conservator uses for formulating a conservation strategy. It carries all the necessary information about the artifact. The accession number or registration number it contains helps to identify the artifact in the collection and also links up the information of conservation treatment given for future references. The document further contains information about the iconographic elements, values and significance, materials used for construction, whether the materials are organic, inorganic or composite in nature. It is the material that gives a brief idea about the possible cause of deterioration on the basis of its nature of decay and the vulnerability to different environmental factors. The shape and the dimension gives the authenticity to the conservator in what condition it is acquired. So now here I am sharing an example of the documentation and condition assessment report prepared for a polychrome urine sculpture. According to the condition assessment, the greasy stains that are observed on all over the surface of the sculpture, along with the losses in the paint layer and in the wood, are further mapped through the photographic documentation and graphical documentation that you can see in the example. An example of the Deepak Mahal at Aichatragarh Fort in Nagore. Nagore Fort has a rich collection of wall paintings, and in this particular image, the plaster layer or the different supports on which painting is done is documented. The Rajasthan has a unique tradition and technique of making arais or kodi plaster. This image reveals the coarse plaster layers as well underneath the final layer of plaster. This helps to understand how the materials have been applied and how this technique has been practiced. Further, this information provides a base for a future conservation treatment, as well as the scientific study of plaster samples help the conservator to use materials that are compatible to original fabric. This image is from the wall painting fragments of Hadirani Mahal at Aichatragarh Fort in Nagore. In this image, some of the paint layer has faded due to the exposure of light. However, in ultraviolet radiation, the considerable amount of organic material that is present in the coloring matter fluoresces. Imaging techniques under different spectra of light further provides necessary information that is not visible in daylight. Based on this, a conservator can understand the application of paint layer, the materials used on it, and further revise a strategy for conservation and restoration using similar material. Moreover, on the basis of imaging, conservators can further analyze the paint layer scientifically or microscopically to identify the exact composition of the coloring matter and the binding media. This helps to retain the authenticity and integrity of the artifact, as well as provides the evidence to the heritage, values, and significance. Here in this image, the UV fluorescence shows the cloud that is painted in the wall paintings of the Shish Mahal at Aichatragarh Fort, which is again not distinct and visible in normal light. On our previous examples, we have found out how materials and technology and their imaging plays a major role in devising a conservation strategy. A conservator often encounters previous restoration work while assessing and conserving an artifact. This image documents the retouching work done to enhance its aesthetic values. However, the conservator has to check the stability and compatibility of such restoration work with the original material fabric, whether the restoration is altering the values and significances or not. Based on these judgments, sometimes previous restorations are removed or tried to minimize if it's affecting the identity of an artifact. Conservators often find difficulty in defining a conservation strategy for an artifact where its original materials are responsible for its deterioration. Here is an example of the iron gall ink deterioration that is happening at the paper, which leads to the charring of the paper. And the other example includes the pigment alteration of the lead pigments that is used at the Hadirani Mahal in Aichatragarh Fort, which got darkened over the time. This is an image of a bahikhata which is used to maintain the accounts of the royal courts. However, as seen in the image, the way it is wrapped around is causing stress and tension on the folds of each folio. This is observed in the form of frayed edges and cracks. However, the binding and the folding technique is a feature of its values and significances. Therefore, efforts can be done only to strengthen the folio on the folds and repair them. This bahikhata was made to wrap around like it, and therefore the conservation decisions should be formed by taking into account that. Along with the photographic documentation or technical imaging, the microscopic study and imaging also helps a conservator to define a conservation strategy. In this image, the blackening or the bioreteration that is happening at the different plaster layers of Aichatragarh Fort in Nagaur is studied through microscopic investigation. It is observed in the microscopic investigation that the appearance of the deterioration phenomena is different according to the porosity and the grain size of the plaster layer. Moreover, the scientific analysis done through the polarized light microscopy shows the presence of fungal spores where the blackening is happening. This helps the conservator to devise a conservation strategy in order to deal with a biodeterioration. On the basis of the documentation and condition assessment, a conservator proposes a treatment methodology for an artifact. If the object is found unstable and needs remedial conservation, it is then treated using compatible materials. This action, however, ensures that no alteration happens, and the treatment should consider the notion of reversibility and minimal intervention. In this image, different adhesives were tested on samples before joining a terracotta object to see its effect. The reversibility and the minimal intervention are the most essential notion on conservation ethics and principle. Our conservation treatment should not limit the scope of future conservation. It is often advised that if suitable and compatible materials are not present, the preventive conservation should be carried out. The principle is understood as referring to the minimizing the use of new material and maximum retention of the original material while performing a conservation work. Documents such as Bura Charter also advises that only doing as much as necessary but as little as possible. This image is of the polychromic sculpture of St. Joe's at the Church of Estella in Spain. The restoration has altered the authenticity, significance, and integrity of the artifact. Therefore, it was considered to restore again to attain a similar appearance as it was before. However, the original material and the identity had been lost through the course of restoration. This is the image of the Ecce Homo or Behold the Man in the sanctuary of Mercy Church in Spain. It is a fresco painted by Elias Garcia Martinez depicting Jesus crowned with thorns. The image depicts the traditional Catholic art. However, the painting got disfigured when restoration was attempted on the face. This alters the significance of the painting, the integrity, as well as the process is irreversible. Conservators face challenges in defining a conservation methodology. However, these two case studies show how the emphasis should be given on the notion of minimal intervention and reversibility. Moreover, a conservation strategy should be formed by understanding the materials and technique and their behavior as well as the deterioration factors.
In this presentation, I have tried to discuss in brief about some of the factors that influence in conservation decision making. Along with these factors, the most significant aspect of the conservation process is that the conservator and the custodians or the curators have to come to a mutual agreement prior to formulating any conservation decision. It is the duty of conservators to make people aware about the conservation ethics and principles. So thank you everyone for being with me throughout the presentation. Thank you to the Abhigya E-Museum for giving me the opportunity to contribute something for a society and to be a part of this wonderful panel. Thank you all once again. Please stay safe and take care.